Welcome to Infos. Welcome to Oil and Gas Training Session. So we are continuing our study on basic instrumentation and control system. So in oil and gas training, it is instrumentation side is very important. So we are our last 7 videos we are discussing about various type of sensing element, transmitter, controller, some basic parts of all elements involved in control system. So in this video, this is a part 8. So welcome to this video. In this video, we are discussing about types of control system. I hope all of you are watched our previous videos. If you didn't watch that one, please go ahead and watch all basic instrumentation from the beginning of part 1. Then only you will get a proper understanding about instrumentation, sensing element, transmitter, controller, control system. So in all idea, then only you can continue, you will get that flow. So please go through the previous links and in different parts of different sections of this training. So in this video, we are discussing about types of control system. We just to understand that one simple control loop we have studied, but in this one, what are the different type of arrangement we can make it to minimize the fluctuation, reduce the fluctuation and avoid the fluctuation to better improvement of the control system, reduce the process upset. What are the various combinations, what are the advanced control system that we are going to discuss today. So welcome to this video. So types of control system. So one is a direct acting and a reverse acting controllers. So basically in this discussion we are going to about controller. So different type of controller. So pneumatic and electronic controller, we just to understand the basics, but in this one, different type of controller. Review this one in our continuing from our various previous section, level indicator is there, that is a level transmitter is there, that is sensing element and transmitter, and controller is there. So level indicator, level transmitter and level controller. Level controller output is coming to LCD. So the indicator signal going to transmitter, transmitter signal going to controller, and the controller signal going to control valve. This is a normal closed control loop, very simple one. My friends and you, if you didn't watch my previous videos, have a look that one, understand what was the indicators and the sensing element, transmitters, separate classes, separate links are there, and the controller and the control valve. So how, what is the control loop, all basic informations are there. Don't miss that one to get the flow of this all entire video, then only you can understand it properly. So better to go ahead and understand my previous videos and review or view or watch my previous videos. So in this one, I am not going to discuss about indicator, transmitter, controller and control valve. So here we are discussing about direct acting controller. So in this one, it is a control loop, a simple control loop. What will happen? And if you instruction said there is a valve is there, it is open position, and water is filling or liquid is filling. So we have to maintain the, suppose example, just to imagine that one, we have to maintain that water level at 50% of the tank capacity, just half of that one. So the set point, so in that case the set point is we are giving to here is 50%. Yeah, so the level indicator is always giving 50%, transmitter is converting and transmitting to the controller. So controller is comparing with the set point, the 50 is incoming signal is 50, set point is 50, 50 minus 50 is 0 is the deviation. So LCV has no other work and he will keep that open where the open position itself. But sudden upset coming, more water or more liquid enter to the tank, and 50% is level indicator sensing element is giving now the reading is 55. So sudden upset in the slight small fluctuation, small offset in the tank level. The reading is increased, or level is increased by up to 55%. So 5% small difference is there. So the LT also converted that one. So here you see 55 is the incoming signal and 50 is the current set point. So the difference is 5% or 5 is the difference is there. So when the level is increasing, so we have to reduce that level. That's the level is increasing, the reading of process value increasing. But the output of the controller also increasing. That is important. Process value increasing. So output of the controller increasing. So he will give the output to the controller to the control valve signal to open more. If this valve has to open little slightly more, then we can reduce that water level or that liquid level again back to 50%. So direct acting controller, when the process value is increasing, process value increasing, output of the controller increasing. Just to have a look, slight change, what is a reverse acting control valve? What is happening reverse acting control valve? Our LI level sensor is there, level transmitter is there, level controller is there. In earlier picture, and the level control valve is placed in the discharge side, but here what is happening? From the controller, output is going to in the back side or the suction side of the tank, and the control valve is in the suction side. So simply this is reverse acting. So how it is reverse acting? When the level is increasing, that is means the LT output or process value increasing, what will happen? It is 55, then what it should do? Output controller is decreasing. So it is 50 by 55. So this one is going to decrease it. He will tell the valve to close little to reduce the water level back to set point. So in direct acting controller, process value increasing, then output is increasing, controller output. But in reverse acting, then the process value increasing, output of the controller is decreasing. So just to read that one, direct acting controller, the output of the controller increases as the increase in the process value, and decreases and PV is decreasing. So in case this PV is decreasing in the direct acting, PV is decreasing like 45, less than 50, then output also decreases. And so process value increasing, output will increase. Process value decreasing, output will decrease. So that is the direct acting and reverse acting. So these are widely using in process operation to fix the valve position where is a suitable for to minimize the upset and the fluctuation of the process variable. So that is in the process itself. So this is widely using controller type of controllers, reverse acting and direct acting. Another example can give that one in different way. It is feedback control system. So look at that one. It is very simple. What is the process? Product is coming and heated product is going out. In the shell side, it is cooled product is enter and hot product is out. So we are heating one fluid using another hot oil. Hot oil is entering from shell tube side, and it's a kettle type reboiler. And hot oil is out, or it is a little bit cold oil is out. So this is this one. So our design is maintaining the product heated product outlet temperature is our aim to maintain. We are maintaining that temperature. Say whatever it is the temperature, you can set it 50 degree or 40 degree C. Whatever rough value you can as an example we can give here. So in that case, temperature transmitter is there. Or sensing element and a transmitter together connected here in this picture. That is possible. Sensing element is in this point, is sensing element, and the transmitter is in this point, and the transmitter signal coming to temperature controller. So set point we can put a 50 degree C. So both are 50 degree C. So there is no output changes is there, and the set point and output is set point and the process value is both same. So the output is producing zero. So I2P is the converter. This is a electronic signal, 4 to 20 milliamps, and it is converted into 3 to 15 PSI. So control valve is open in the same position. There is no change in the control valve opening closing. So hot oil is flow is constant, and it is developing. It is continuously heating. So in case it is temperature changing, so it will adjust accordingly. So what is happening in the some more advances in the feedback control system? The outcome of the controller action is fed back to the controller for corrective action. In feedback control system, the outcome of the controller, this is the outcome of the controller action fed back to the controller. It will again fed back to the controller for correcting action. So that is again changing, that temperature is going back and it is going back, it is going. So this control loop is controlling and it is feeding back to the correct controller again and again and again. So let us see that what is the other control system for advancing on this one. Feedback controller can only react to the correct the load upset after in an error is detected between the process variable and set point. What is it written? That feedback controllers can only react once any changes in the process upset, then only controller will react. So it will react for a load upset after an error or difference is detected between process variable and or process value and the set point. So then only he will take a corrective action. So but feedback controller recovery is very slow for major upset. So any upset, process upset, like a temperature changing to higher side or lower side, the controller recovery is it will take some time and a slow recovery. So for to cover up this one, there is another one is feed forward controller. Look at that picture. It is exactly a feedback control system, TT, TC and TCV. All are same. What is happening when feed forward control system, how it is modifying? Look at that one. There is another controller coming to the picture. What is it? It is a flow controller, or you can say it is a mathematical calculator, you can say. Then say, and the one FT signal is connecting to that one. In advance, that is flow of the hot oil always taking that one. So two input is getting to this controller. From the main controller, temperature controller output is coming, plus flow transmitter one from the field, hot oil flow is also taking. Plus one more item is there, product temperature and flow also it is taking. Product flow and temperature also taking. The sigma is mean is a mathematical computation programming logical box, sigma and x. So advanced instrumentation engineers only can explain this one, what happened inside this one. But the process engineers or process operators in the process study people no need to understand what is inside this one. So this reading also taking, so all reading, what is a temperature taking from the product line, temperature taking from the product in line, so flow also from the product in before entering to the heat exchanger, taking to the second controller from the output of the first controller, all this reading is connecting, taking that one for feed forward controller. So a better accurate perfect temperature measurement, temperature control is possible in this reboiler. So very very minor upset understand in advance to the controller before giving the output to the control valve. That is possible in this feed forward controller. Let us see what is it. Feed forward controller work together with a feedback controller. Feed forward controller adjusts the output of the feedback controller. So feed forward controller adjusts the output of the feed forward controller, feedback controller, by monitoring process changes in advance. So it will some more variables, another process value or process variable, it will read and monitor in advance. Then it will adjust the feedback controller output in advance. So to maintain, to reduce the disturbance and the fluctuation, it will work a perfect combination of a control system. This action reduces the fluctuations. So continuing that feed forward control system. Feed forward control is one of the most widely used advanced control system techniques in process oil control, process control industry. Feed forward offers many advantages over feedback controller. Feed forward can compensate the load upset, any load upset, minor or major upset, before they are detected by the control system as an error. In feedback control system, a load upset and disturbs the process variable measurement. So the system upset until feedback control brings the process variable measurement back to set point. The basic principle of feed forward control is to measure the disturbance in advance and thus preventing the disturbance upsetting process variable signal being controlled. So we have studied about feed forward and backward controller, direct and indirect, reverse acting controller, direct acting and reverse acting controller. Another one is a cascade control system. Cascade control, let us see what is cascade control system. Tank level is there, level indicator, level transmitter, level controller and control valve is there. It's a normal acting control loop, basic closed control loop is there. But the pump is taking from the tank, and the pump is, imagine that it is a centrifugal pump, suction side, discharge side is there. So sudden valve is, in case valve is fully open, sudden drain out the water, there is no level will get the suction side of the pump, so pump can drain out and it can cavitate, damage the pump. So only level, sometime we feel that now maybe it will work very smoothly on the process value of the level, process variable, level sensing and a level controlling loop. So, but sometime it's a flow is also important factor here. Look at that one, a pump is there, pump is taking the flow from the tank. So flow is also sometime very important factor. So to minimize the fluctuation and reduce the disturbance, this advanced control system is applicable here. Not only level is the, not only only the parameter, but flow also, process flow also very, very important parameter here. So say, so how it is modifying that cascade control system? Look at that one. In the normal mode, only one controller, that is LIC and control valve. But in the cascade mode is, what is cascade? Another controller adder here. So read that first controller name is a master, second controller name is a slave. So another one controller is added here, it is called FIC. From where the input is getting, FIT, FIC, that is the flow of the discharge line of the pump. FIC is getting, that is FT is there and converting there. So in this controller, two input is coming. One is from the flow input, what is the flow set, set point is there. And another input is coming from the master controller, that is a level input is coming. After comparing the set point level controller, set point is compared with the set point, that output, what is the deviation, that output is receiving the second controller, slave, that is the controller name is slave, master and slave. So remember that one in a simple way to remember, a cascade controller is there, two controller and one control valve. Two controller, one control valve. That is a simple equation you have to remember and keep in mind. Two controller, one control valve is cascade controller. So earlier, just to remember that one, in earlier the single control loop, the control valve name was LCV, that is a level control valve. In this one, control valve name is changed simply, it is a flow control valve. Because this control valve is receiving the action only from the flow controller. That's why the control valve name is change it to flow control valve. So FIC and FCV. So the second controller is active here and the first controller master is actually sleeping passive type controller. So controller, second controller receiving two signal and creating an output comparing with the flow and level. So to minimize the fluctuation in the tank, when the flow is also increasing, it will reduce the motor speed, pump speed and or control, close the, it can, sorry, it can close the valve little bit and maintain the flow in a smooth and not fluctuated manner. So minimize the fluctuation properly. Okay. So in the normal control mode, the LIC operate, level controller operate, normal control mode operating LCV, and the level control is achieved in the normal control, the previous one. And in if the tank level, inlet flow of the tank fluctuates, then the normal control will not be capable to keeping the level steady. So in that case, cascade control system uses two or more controllers interconnected in series to provide a better control of a process variable. When two different process variables are so related as level and flow in the above case, that a change in one affect the control of the other, the cascade control is required to make a closer control. In cascade control system, the output of the primary or master controller is taken as a set point of the secondary or the slave controller. Primary controller should be an auto, and the secondary controller should be on cascade to operate like this. In the given situation, secondary variable set point is adjusted from the deviation of primary variable, that is level. Secondary control action result from a combination of flow and level deviation. Cascade controller is using another example in the temperature of the our reboiler example. So let's see that one here. What is happening? Normal mode is TCV, temperature transmitter, temperature controller, and a temperature control valve. But in the cascade mode, it is the flow of the hot oil is also taking, and the control valve name is changed to FCV. This is the best one of the best example of the cascade controller. Flow and temperature both are checking, and both are taking care and controlling reboiler temperature, reboiler product temperature properly and very effectively. Master controller of the product outlet temperature and the secondary slave control is the steam flow. So steam flow is controlled by two input, deviation of master controller and deviation of secondary controller. Another type is compressor capacity control system. In this one, typical pressure control of the centrifugal compressor. Suction side is there, this is the suction side, and this is the discharge. This is the suction side of the compressor. This is the suction. Suction is entering from the suction scrubber. Suction scrubber, and from the suction scrubber, and liquid is removing, and the gas is entering to the compressor suction side. This is the suction side, and this is the drive side, motor and or gas turbine side. And this is the discharge side, is going to the cooler, and this is the delivery side. It is the delivery to the customer or the other process, or prevent surge protection. This is the anti-surge control valve. It is there. It is going back to the suction. This is the process here. And here it is another method is there. Two control valve controller is there. One is taking from the pressure from the suction pressure, taking to the suction pressure controller, and another one is discharge pressure is taking from the discharge pressure controller. So typical pressure control of the centrifugal compressor. Compressor speed varies as per the changes in the suction and discharge pressure by using a LSS. What is a new component is showing? Low selector switch. So control room operator can select the which side pressure you want to control. So if you want to control in the suction side pressure, the LSS can select the left side. Or if you want to control the pressure in the discharge side, you can select to the right side selection. So this will be in the, once you select the discharge pressure side, then suction side pressure control system will be inactive. So you can select in the both side. So LSS output is sent to drive mechanism like GT control, gas turbine control, motor control, or void coupling, etc., etc. So this is another type of example of advanced control system using a low selector switch. So this is widely using in compressor suction and discharge pressure control system. Another one is a split range. there is a pipeline, is a gas from main header, it is going. So this is our normal control loop, like a pressure transmitter is there and pressure controller is there up to that one. So the pressure transmitter sending the signal to here and main pressure controller is there. But after the controller, there is a change is there. After the controller, normally a control valve it is going. So one transmitter, controller and control valve. This is the system. But here it is the controller output, that is a 4 to 20 milliamps or 3 to 15 psi or 0 to 100 kpi. So like that, this one, so these are the output. Output of the controller is say imagine 4 to 20 milliamps or 3 to 15 psi. That is dividing to some different control valve. One controller output is giving to two or more control valve. So see that one here, it is 0 to 100 is the output, that is that output is giving to 0 to 30 giving to one controller output, one control final control element. What is that final control element? That is 0 to 30, only up to that is 30 percentage opening is giving to a compressor. So when the pressure is increasing above the set point, so first it will open, only the compressor will start and compress the gas little, taking from the gas line, and it will compress and sending to other various customers or various other process. Only 30%. So minor upset is there, only compressor can control that one to maintain that the pressure up to gas or main header pressure up to set point. Only compressor can. Compressor always in the below then 0% opening, that one at the set point level compressor is running with minimum load. It will not take the feed from here, suction from here. But up to 30% opening, only the small variation is there, compressor will take and control the, maintain the pressure in the header. But if the, in case the pressure is increasing again and again, or the output is increasing more than 30%, so up to 30 to 70, what will happen? Output is giving to another control valve, is connected to header, that is going to fuel gas line. So we can reduce and bringing back to the temperature pressure up to the set point again. Still 70 to 100 another control valve is going to, so there is a minor various big changes is in the pressure in the gas header. So first will compressor will open, still not possible to maintain the pressure back to the normal set point. So again gas to fuel gas line is open, that pressure control valve is open, still it is pressure is increasing. Then finally compressor running and this one PCV A2, that valve is open, fully open up to 70%. Then gas to flyer, so major upset is there, you can manage it to gas to flyer. So in 100% opening, 100% output, compressor running, valve fuel gas to the fuel gas valve is fully open and gas to flyer will be fully open. So this is the best example of a split range. What is the meaning? Split range. So the controller output is a single controller. It is dividing into various final control element. Here it is three. So if you, for a simple understanding, better to remember that one controller and more than two or more than final control element is called split range control system. In the above illustration, split range control is used to control the gas header pressure by using three controllers. I already read that one. You just to read this all, what is happening this one. And zero output gas compressor will be on and minimum load. But in 30, when it is reaching, and it will go to full load. But both other valves are closed. Like that one, in 30 to 70, compressor in full load and PCV A2 open minimum to maximum in between 30 and 70. So when it is 100, that third valve will open. So that one, this is also another example. PCV A is there in the tank pressure controlling. Although up to 50% of the controller output, PCV A, that is the gas to compressor, will take care. And 50 to 100% output for valve B, that will gas to flyer will take care. These are the common control system, split range control system connected to in oil gathering station separator gas outlet normally. So to avoid flaring too much gas to flare, first it will go to customers through the compressor. But in case output pressure is exceeding or separator pressure is increasing more and more, in that case you can send it to gas to flare. This is also another one. It is tank level is there, but in this one it is a different scenario is here. And when the tank level is increasing above the set point, what is it will take that this one level and going back to tank 0 to 75% it will recycling system, recycling system to avoid. But again still valve is increasing more, tank level increasing more and more, then another valve is there, it is taking care of the valve, discharge lane will open. So it is a split range, another example. So pump is there and it's another example of a split range. So whenever you get time to go to the field, you understand that when advanced control system techniques are using in your field, just to go to and take your P&ID and read that one, how this advanced cascade, speed forward, feedback, reverse acting, forward acting, and various type of split range control system are working out. Another one is ratio control. Ratio control is using in many places, many industrial process like furnace and burner management system, boilers. Even in our new gen cars also using the fuel air ratio controller. So in this one picture you can see that one ratio, one ratio we can set it is a example 1:3. One unit fuel is entering to the furnace, 3 unit air should enter, because in combustion equation CH4 plus O2, O2 we have to supply excess air to get a complete combustion. So air should be always more than 50% or 75% or 100% more than the fuel. So 1:2 or 1:3 ratio we can fix it according to the complete combustion equation, stoichiometric equation. So ratio we can fix it. So whenever the fuel is always fuel reading is taking, fuel flow rate is taking by FT1 at the flow transmitter. So that is going to ratio controller, ratio calculation. From that one, this is the ratio controller. Then it is going to FT2, taking air fuel ratio, air flow. Then it is calculating according to that one, the fuel controller is there. So it will open air valve according to the ratio fixing. Say example 1:2 or 1:3. So ratio control architecture is used to maintain the flow rate of one dependent controlled feed stream in a process at a defined or specified proportion relative to that of another independent wild feed stream in order to control the composition of a resultant mixture. So this method is very suitable to maintain complete combustion in a furnace. So two flow is there. So one is that is a dependent control feed, another one is a wild feed. So control valve is in the here in this example it's in the air line. So based on the fuel air ratio, the air will always open more whenever the fire increase. In case fuel is increase more, according to the ratio, air will increase. When the fire reduce, so fuel will reduce first, then air will reduce second. Like that one, ratio control working smoothly. This is the one of the another controls, types of control system, ratio control. Ratio control architectures are most commonly used to combine two feed streams to produce a mixed flow of a desired composition or physical property downstream. Ratio control architecture involves the use of an independent wild stream and a dependent stream called controlled feed. Another example is showing here, flow fraction ratio controller. So it is here also you can see a wild feed is there, a straight run gasoline is given the example. The flow rate is taking from an FT, here it is showing only F it is.
So that is a flow sensor transmitter, and the controller name is giving in FFC. FFC means flow controller. So two flow is taking care here, and the controlled feed is the octane booster or octane another feed line. So according to the straight-run gasoline and octane booster, the ratios we can fix it, that the flow fraction we can fix it. According to that, the octane feed is booster, this controller output signal to maintain that one, the mixed flow according to that flow fraction ratio. So this is another example using in refineries. So to maintain that gasoline octane value. Another one is advanced control system, ratio relay controller with remote input. So that is analyzer is connecting in mixer flow, analyzer is there. So analyzer always giving that ratio, checking the ratio of a mixer flow, whether it is correct or not, that is AC analyzer. So analyzer output also taking to the relay unit. So flow transmitter is there, FT, and the ratio relay is the RY. So analyzer analysis controller is taking here. The mixer flow output ratio is checking by analyzer. So that also taking to consideration here. And wild feed is here, one flow, FT is there. That reading is entering to ratio or relay ratio input, and controlled feed is here to taking care to the controller. So based on that one, they can adjust the output of the controller and maintaining that one, making that sure that one the controlled feed is always output flow is always maintaining the ratio. So that is another one. Another example is override controller. Override controller always it is using in boiler furnace area. So boiler furnace area we are using fuel, that is this is the fuel line and combustion air. And fuel line there is a valve is there and control valve, flow control valve is there. And in the combustion air there is a dampener is there. Dampener, this is also a typical example of a valve, airflow maintaining, you can fully close and partially open, 50% open, both it is possible. So airflow you can control by using dampener. So what are the system here? It is a fuel line, it is a control valve is there. So fuel line, a flow transmitter is there. So airflow rate you can take it from one side, from this combustion air, airflow you can take and fuel line also you can take. Here the important is there is two selectors which is there, low selection and high selection. You can see HS and LS, low selection and high selection. So in this case it is whenever you want to increase firing demand, whenever it is firing demand you increase, when the maybe downside steam, more steam is taking out or increase in the boiler load. So firing demand is increasing, in that case high selection switches automatically will activate, that will increase the dampener will open more, slightly open more, then based on that one that reading will go to low selector switch and fuel line will increase open more. So whenever the simplified way if you can talk to that one, whenever the firing is increased it will selection automatically go to the high selection switch and it will take to combustion air dampener more open, then according to air open it will again going to fuel flow control valve will open more, just opposite of the same firing is reduced, then fuel will cut off first, reduce the fuel flow, then based on the fuel flow reducing, based on the ratio controller, it will go back to air dampener slowly, after some time it will close to maintain the ratio. So ratio with the cross limiting override control strategy. These are using regularly in furnaces and boiler burner management system. A select element receives two input signals and forwards one of them onward in the signal path. A low select, shown below to the left, passes the lowest of the two signals, while a high select, shown to the right, passes a larger value onward. These are the regularly, it's a very advanced system, so normally it is very rare it is using the control system scenario. So if you have any chance to get you have to go your field and or P&ID reading possibilities there, you have to understand and read this one. But in our video session, we are planning to bring the P&ID session. Later we are taking care to read the P&ID, understand this type of all whatever the available practical examples using different type of control system in various planters that we are preparing soon. Definitely we will get it soon and we will discuss that one. Time being, I am signing off. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to this channel for timely updation and information. Definitely our regular update is getting our Telegram channel, enforced by Hamza Vivava, for various updates. And thanks for watching my video. Hopefully you have enjoyed this one, and kindly I am requesting all of you to watch all previous videos to get a proper understanding on oil and gas training. Thanks for watching. Definitely we will come back soon. Thank you.